Right, girls and boys, what actually is this?
It's solar panel.
Well, it's actually a solar cell. Does anyone know how a solar cell actually works?
I think it sits on the top of a roof or some part of, to get electricity. Like, the sun hits it and it stores electricity, so then you can use it in household appliances.
Okay, so the energy that the solar cell's using is what?
Sunlight.
Is that a renewable energy or a non-renewable energy?
Renewable.
So it's obviously very, very good for our environment, isn't it? Yep. So we have to work out how this is going to convert light energy into what sort of energy will it produce?
Solar energy, isn't it?
Well, what's it going to create through the wires? What can we create with this?
Electricity.
Fantastic, right. Electricity. So I'm wondering whether one of you can come and show how we can make this circuit actually work. Now, while he's doing that, what angle do you think that solar cell will need to be in?
Well, we need to be in angle so the sun can hit it.
Excellent. So that's it. All right. Okay, show the group. We have success. It has produced what sort of energy?
Electricity.
Let's check the efficiency of the gas heater. So the gas energy rating is 4.5. And the indoor gas heat emission rating is 6 stars.
Which is really good. Now, we've just had a look around the school at some energy efficient type things that we have around the school. What types of things have we got in our school that's actually working really well?
These lights.
Okay, so what's how have they improved since the old lights that we used to have with the fluoro tubes?
Well, the old lights had really big bulbs, and they used a lot of power, and these ones are more energy efficient.
Fantastic. And what happens to our lights after a certain period of time?
Well, the lights turn off.
Okay, so after a period of time, the lights will turn off quite naturally to conserve energy. I thought it might be a really good idea if we actually made some prompts for some of the classroom teachers at Coolbinia to actually be a little bit more efficient with our lighting. So what could we do, or what could we tell our classroom teachers as they exit the classroom?
Have a little catchphrase kind of thing.
Catchy phrase to turn them off. Fantastic. All right, so what I want you to do is actually have a think about a catchy little phrase that would remind classroom teachers to actually turn their light switches off as they exit a room. So have a think and grab your textures and see if you can design a really good little prompt with a catchy phrase, and you need a picture as well. Okay, off you go. Be brave and save. But how? What do they need to do? You need to be really clear with your little phrase. What action do you want the person to do?
Turn the lights off.
Okay, so how can you put that into a nice catchy phrase?
Find words that rhyme with it and stuff.
Fantastic. So can you think of a good one?
Not yet.
Who's thought of a good catchy phrase?
You know, that's kind of from the song, Wake Me Up Before You Go, because turn me off before you go, because I won't turn off by myself.
Great, fantastic.
We were wondering if you could maybe put this up next to your light switch so that you remember to turn off your lights before you go out of the classroom so we can save more energy in our school.
I'd love to. Thank you. Great.
Okay.